Senator Clinton, good evening. The number one issue for Americans of both parties is the economy, and today the news is simply not good. Markets around the world are in a tailspin because of fears of a U.S. recession. So far this year, the Dow has lost nearly 9%. How much money would your stimulus plan put in the pockets of the average South Carolinian?
Well, Joe, I'm glad you started with the economy because that is the number one issue. What's been happening in the markets, what's been happening with the home mortgage crisis, $100 a barrel oil, so many of the issues that are really at the kitchen tables of Americans today and what they're talking to me about. We have to stimulate the economy. I began calling for some kind of economic action plan back at the beginning of December. I have a package of $110 billion. 70 of that would go toward dealing with the mortgage crisis, which unfortunately I don't think that President Bush has really taken seriously enough. I would have a moratorium on home foreclosures for 90 days to try to help families work it out so that they don't lose their homes. We're in danger of seeing millions of Americans become basically, you know, homeless and losing the American dream. I want to have an interest rate freeze for 5 years because these adjustable rate mortgages, if they keep going up, the problem will just get compounded, and we need more transparency in the market. Then I think we need to give people about $650 if they qualify, which will be millions of people, to help pay their energy bills this winter. You know, there are so many people on fixed incomes and working people who are not going to be able to afford the spike in energy costs. We need to make sure that we start jump-starting the jobs in this country again. That's why I want to put money into clean energy jobs, green-collar jobs, and also make sure we have a fund that will help communities deal with the consequences of the home foreclosure crisis and make sure the unemployment system is up to the task. And then we will have money for rebates, but let's make them the right rebates. Everything we know about President Bush's plans would leave 50 to 70 million Americans out, because a lot of our seniors on fixed incomes don't pay income taxes, but that doesn't mean they're immune from the energy costs and the health care costs and everything else that's going up around them. And we have a huge number of working people who thankfully don't pay income tax. They pay payroll tax. They pay a lot of other taxes. President Bush's plan would do nothing to help them. But thankfully, we've got leaders of the Congressional Black Caucus here who are going to make sure that we get the right kind of stimulus. And that's what the Democrats are going to support. It's imperative we do it. It's a part of economic justice, which on Dr. King's holiday is part of his unfinished legacy.
All right. Senator Obama?
Well, you know, we do meet on the King holiday, and I think it's important to remember that in the March on Washington, where Dr. King always talks about, or it's always repeated, the dream speech that is so famous, that march was for jobs as well as justice. And unfortunately, we have not made the kind of progress that we need in having a balanced economy, and George Bush has made it worse. George Bush has consistently skewed our tax code to the wealthy. He has squandered billions of dollars in a war that I believe should never have been authorized and should have never been waged. We have not made the investments that are needed in our school system. You travel around South Carolina along the corridor of shame, and you've got children who are going to schools that were built in the 1800s. And they are not able to compete in an international economy. So it is absolutely critical right now to give a stimulus to the economy. And Senator Clinton mentioned tax rebates. That wasn't the original focus of her plan. I think recently she has caught up with what I had originally said, which is we've got to get taxes into the tax cuts into the pockets of hardworking Americans right away. And it is important for us to make sure that they are not just going to the wealthy. They should be going to folks who are making $75,000 a year or less, and they should be going to folks who only pay payroll tax but typically are not paying income tax. If we do that, then not only can we stimulate the economy, those are the folks who are most likely to spend money right away.
Do you agree with her $650 is a good number for a tax rebate?
Well, I think that we are going to have to get some immediate money. What I do is I say for a typical family, $500 for a tax rebate per family. But also for senior citizens, get a supplement to their Social Security check, because they get that every month. We know exactly how to do it, and that would provide seniors all across the country right away some money to help pay for their heating bills and other expenses that they've got right now.
Correct me if I'm wrong, Senator Edwards, your plan does not call for a tax rebate, does it?
No, that's exactly right. Can I start by saying how proud I am to be here tonight? A debate sponsored by the Congressional Black Caucus on Dr. King's holiday, and particularly on this night when we're honoring the legacy of Dr. King, who central to his work was the idea of fighting for real equality between the races, fighting to end poverty in America, his famous Poor People's Campaign, which he was engaged in at the time of his death, fighting for garbage workers, actually, in Memphis. And the chasm between the rich and the poor in America is wide. It is getting worse. The rich are getting richer, and we've added 5 million people to the poverty rolls just over the course of the last 7 years.
The stimulus package?
Here's what we should do. That's why I'm getting to this. What Bush does is he leaves 50 million, as Hillary pointed out, 50 million Americans. They're low-income Americans and moderate-income Americans. They're completely left out of his stimulus package. If we're actually going to deal with the legacy of Dr. King, if we're going to deal with this issue of poverty, and I have a comprehensive plan to do that, it is the cause of my life to end poverty in this country, we also have to include all Americans in this stimulus plan. Now, one difference between what I proposed and what my two colleagues have proposed is I have done something that not only stimulates the economy, but creates long-term benefits, investment in green infrastructure, which creates jobs. Instead of just getting money out in the short term, this will actually create jobs over the long term, create green infrastructure. Yes, we need to do something about the mortgage crisis. I want to mention one last thing. There is one other issue that was mentioned in passing by the two of them, which is the issue of jobs. And there is a difference between myself and my colleagues on this issue of jobs, because they both supported the Peru trade deal. My view is the Peru trade deal was similar to NAFTA, and this is crucial to the state of South Carolina. Crucial to the state of South Carolina and jobs in South Carolina. South Carolina has been devastated by NAFTA and trade deals.
But
like
I just
NAFTA.
Want to be precise. What you're proposing are really long-term objectives. In terms of a short-term stimulus package, you disagree with them on an immediate tax rebate.
No. What I'm saying is, if we do what we should do to green the economy, if we change our unemployment insurance laws, modernize them to make them available to more people, to more Americans, if we in fact get help to the states, which gets money straight into the economy, and we deal with the mortgage crisis in a serious way with a home rescue fund to provide transitional financing for those people who are about to lose their homes, all those things will stimulate the economy.
Well, all right. I'll let both of you respond, but let Senator Obama respond first.
Let me just respond to a couple things. I think the idea of green jobs is important, which is why that's central to my energy plan. But Wolf, you're exactly right. That is a long-term agenda. That is not going to deal with the immediate crisis we have right now. You've got the European markets drop 5%. The expectation is that the Dow Jones tomorrow may do the same. We could be sliding into an extraordinary recession unless we stimulate the economy immediately. That's point number one. Point number two on trade. John is exactly right that you travel around South Carolina, and you see the textile mills that John's father worked in, closed all over the region. And it is absolutely true that NAFTA was a mistake. I know that Hillary on occasion has said that this was, just last year, said this was a boon to the economy. I think it has been devastating because our trade agreements did not have labor standards and environmental standards that would assure that workers in the U.S. were getting a square deal. But the only thing I want to differ on, John, is this whole notion of Peru. The Peru trade deal had labor and environmental agreements in it. Peru is an economy the size of New Hampshire. Over 90% of the goods coming from Peru already come in under various free trade agreements. And John, you voted for permanent trade relations with China, which I think anybody who looks at how we structure trade in this country would tell you has been the biggest beneficiary and the biggest problem that we have with respect to trade, particularly because they're still manipulating the currency.
I'll let you respond, but Senator Clinton, I want to get back to the issue of an immediate stimulus for the economy, because who knows what the markets are going to be like tomorrow, and there are a lot of people out there who are suffering already, but go ahead and respond.
Well, I want to just clarify a couple of points. My original plan was $70 billion in spending with a $40 billion contingency that was part of the original plan in order to have that money available for tax rebates. I hope that we could do it through spending, and here's why. I don't want to necessarily open up the tax codes while we've got Republicans in the Senate who are going to try to come back and open up making Bush's tax cuts permanent. I understand that that's a real risk.